Hey YouTube, what's up guys? Welcome to another fragrance review, and today I'm going to tell you more about Amouage Lyric Man. Now this is the fragrance I don't own a bottle of, and I went through quite a few of samples and small deacons over the years, and I think I'm finally ready to tell you more about this fragrance. So Amouage Lyric Man was released in 2008, and the notes listed are bergamot, lime, rose, angelica, orange blossom, galbanum, nutmeg, ginger, saffron, pine tree, vanilla, sandalwood, incense and musk. When I first spray this fragrance on, it opens with a huge fresh blast of citruses mixed with fresh, clean, almost soapy rose. Citruses I get are mostly lime. As it dries down, the rose is starting to get sweeter, and I do get a lot of angelica coming into play later on. You get that sweet, herbal, almost spicy vibe from angelica. It kind of, you know, tickles your nose. And as the time goes by, the fragrance and the rose is starting to get rounder and rounder, smoother, almost musky. In the dry down, you definitely get vanilla, which adds sweetness to this fragrance, but it's not heavy vanilla, it's always light and kind of airy. You also get a bit of pine tree popping out of that wonderful, nice, sweet dry down. And I would say I also get some creaminess from sandalwood. Amouage Lyric Man will give you anywhere between 10 to 12 hours. For the first few, it will project quite loud. Then it kind of does settle down closer to the skin, but it's still not very quiet. It's still noticeable, and I think it's a great fragrance when we talk about its performance, like most Amouage fragrances in the first place. It seems to work quite well in all seasons, though if it's hotter, then those citrusy notes kind of do fade away a bit faster, but it does work great in all seasons. It smells very romantic, very sophisticated, very elegant, and it's not your typical rose fragrance. Now, this fragrance does not necessarily suit my personal taste, and that is one of the reasons why I still do not own a bottle, though later on I would not mind maybe getting this one in my collection, but I would definitely love to smell this one on a riot man. Now, I see why some guys might think it's quite feminine and hard to pull off, but in my opinion, if you have enough confidence and you do not need a fragrance to confirm your masculinity, then you can definitely pull this one off. I wouldn't be worried if I was a guy pulling this one off, as well as I think women shouldn't be pulled off by it being marked as a fragrance for men, because I think both genders can equally successfully pull this wonderful rose fragrance off. Okay, thank you guys for watching, and see you soon with another video. Bye YouTube.